Hello. This summer, a seemingly unlikely pair visited our booth in Lowestoft. Manwar is a former jihadist, a man once described as one of the most influential propagandists for the radical Islamist message in the UK. He trained in Afghanistan, Kashmir and Burma, but he bitterly regrets this. Describing himself now as a moderate imam, he lives in Suffolk, where he runs a charity called Jimas, which aims, amongst other things, to encourage people not to fight in Syria or join so-called Islamic State. Ivan is a former member of the English Defence League, but he's since changed his views too. An invitation to a mosque eventually led to Ivan meeting Manwar, and after the murder of Lee Rigby, he got back in touch to organise a multicultural event in honour of the young soldier. We join these two looking back over how they bridged a gap that so many others can't.
We stand on the street to show that people like yourselves, but when you do the research properly, you know what I mean, you only realise you can't hate Islam and blame every Muslim, or you can't dislike Islam. You've just got to make that first step.
You know, I'm just so glad that I also had, if I might say, courage to contact the EDO and then eventually met you. Because I must admit, I was a little bit fearful as well, frightened, because I imagined you to be rough. Well, not physically beat me up, but, you know angry and start swearing or something.
I was apprehensive as well, because I don't know what it was.
We're all human beings, and deep down inside, even in my days when I'm in the battlefield, so to speak, because I was, as you know, recruiting and fundraising and whatnot, I was still human. I had emotions. You know, we had snowball fight in the camps in Afghanistan to, you know, taking little kids to restaurants to feed them. So I was human in that sense. And somebody else could have tapped into that.
To be fair, I was thinking earlier about when did I first sort of really think we'll drop the hatred. I think it was when my partner Jenny came along. But I think it's her love that made, that softened me. Because before I was on my own, I was a single parent with two kids, sort of stuck in my own little rut.
Yeah, in my case, it wasn't a single moment or a single incident or a single person, an epiphany. One particularly poignant moment was in Lahore in Pakistan, in the training camp, when a guy came to me and said to me, oh, you're going to go back to England and start the jihad there, are you? And we had just learned how to make bombs, actually, you know, from sugar and flour and stuff like that. And that struck me because at that time, even at that time, none of us had any inkling or a shadow of yearning to do anything hostile in our own country to our own people. So it kind of puzzled me. And what do you mean? Jihad is not in England or Europe. It's in where I was, against Russians or Indians, what have you. Then seeing something at the camp, for example, the corruption of the leaders to the poverty of the people and how we're not serving their interests. I'm thinking, why are we here? I look at all the opportunities and all the kind of luxuries, you like, we enjoy at home. Whether we're on polar ends, opposites or not, we share common values and wishes, if you like, or dreams. You know, there are an awful lot of people out there who love their country, and that's a common thing. You love the country, I love the country. Our country.
There's no good arguing all the time, do you know what I mean? I know we don't agree on everything. No. I don't think we ever will, but we've got this basis there, and it's a good start. And we've just got to build the foundations up.
Exactly.
Manwar and Ivan, recorded by Linda Walker from BBC Radio Suffolk.